Well, the shutdown has widespread impact on the Central Coast.
Action News reporter Caitlin Conrad takes a look at what the reopening will mean for some local agencies. She's live from Monterey tonight.
Well, Aaron, transportation agencies on the Central Coast have really been feeling the pinch from this shutdown, and the effects could be lasting. Bus service on the Central Coast has been feeling the pinch ever since the government closed its pocketbook, and the temporary reopening may not be enough to tide it over.
It's almost what we need.
Monterey Salinas Transit has been missing $8 million in its operating budget since October, money the federal government owes the agency.
We are currently using our local cash reserves to fund that difference. If the funding doesn't come soon, we will run out of our cash reserves eventually, and we'll have to start paring back services to the community.
Carl Sidorek with MST is worried the government won't be open long enough to release the funds, as it typically takes a month. Meanwhile, the transportation agency for Monterey County says the shutdown could have a domino effect on its Imjin Parkway project.
Basically, we needed one signature from the federal government to sign off on this project, and then we could apply for state funding.
Any delays could delay construction, set to start this year. And even with the government open, the project is still in limbo until everything is back up to speed.
We still don't really know what that means for us, because we don't know if that person's back in the office. We don't know how long it's going to take them to catch up on the backlog in order to process our application in particular.
The shutdown has had a trickle effect all around, even impacting small community events like Whale Fest, which relies on speakers and even ships from the Monterey Bay National Marine Sanctuary.
Because NOAA is a government agency, yes. And so, yes, it affected us, and we needed to look into what we could do to keep the Whale Fest as interactive and active as always.
They were supposed to have speakers from the National Marine Sanctuary at Whale Fest tomorrow. It's still going to go on. They're going to have instead a keynote from Oceana. And then there's going to likely be some employees back on the job tomorrow from NOAA who may be able to come, but they're not going to be able to have a table or an exhibit like they have in the past because they haven't had the time to prepare and get all the volunteers they need for this big event. Dan, Aaron.
Caitlin, thank you.